y'all, Bridget Bartlett here with My Vision Agency, and today I want to show you something that I actually created for my own business that I had to share with you guys because I think it'll really help you. If you're a software reseller, you likely have an issue controlling all of the email addresses for your third-party software. Now, it's really easy with high level. When we create an account in our workflow, we can easily create all of the accounts with the same email, but what if a customer already has an account with that third-party tool? Or what if, for some reason, when they create the account, they use a different email address? This becomes a nightmare when you are trying to audit accounts. Now, we have this option up here for the email, and we can add additional emails here, and that is definitely necessary to make it searchable. But we don't always want to change the main email address because they've used a different email for a specific tool. Now, like I said, we can build this out in our workflows here, and you can see in this example that I do have our social autopilot, which is Brand Blast, and when the user account is created, it goes through this workflow, and one of the steps in that workflow is to send the information via webhook to Brand Blast, and it will create that account for our social autopilot. And then when they access the dashboard here for the social autopilot, they have the ability to log in using that same email address. But like I said, there are times when that does not work because they already have an account with that email address, maybe with someone else or directly through the company. Or maybe, like I said, they've registered their email because you have to send them a registration link and they use a different email. Okay, so this is what I created to help me keep track of that. So when I'm doing audits, I know whose account goes with which user. All right. Now, of course, we are in high level. So if you are interested in signing up for high level or you're already a high level customer, I want to encourage you to go to myvisionagency.com. You can sign up for our free community. I am live 5 days a week with open office hours. I have all kinds of courses, 60 plus tools that you can access, and so much more. So definitely check that out. You can choose here if you're a current high level customer, and then you'll go to the correct option there. If you say no, then you'll go to the link where you can create a high level free trial, and you will receive a free membership in my reseller program. If you say yes, you're going to go to a link where you will receive info about joining my reseller program. Now inside, let's go ahead and create this. I'm going to show you how I built it all out. It's important to note this is in the additional tools tab so that you can stay easily organized when you are doing your audits or looking up your customer accounts. So let's first go into the settings, and we need to create our fields here. So I'm going to go to custom fields. And the first thing that we want to do is create our folder. So I'm going to call this other tools. And we can keep this as a contact object, but if you did have custom objects built in to your account, you could even choose that as well. So I'm just going to save. Now we have our folder. Let's go into our folder for other tools. And now we want to start adding our fields. Now, what I encourage you to do is add a single line field. Now, it's not going to recognize that we've put an email address there. It's just an informational field. So I'm going to go ahead and select that there. And let's put the name of the tool. Now, in my case, it would be like AI Coach, for example. And we can go ahead and save that. In another example, I know all of the members of our program have access to the AI Ads Manager. So I'm going to say AI Ads Manager. And it's still going to be in the other tools folder here. And then we can also add one more. So let's say the AI Leads. And it's still in the other tools item here. So let's save. And now let's go back into a profile here. And you can see if I click into a random profile, and if we scroll down to the other tools folder, you'll see the three different fields for the tools that we have created here. Now, of course, the first step, once you've created this, is to add this to your onboarding workflow. So I'm going to go into the automations here, and let's just create a workflow, and we're going to pretend that this is the workflow when someone signs up. So our trigger is going to be the order form or order submitted. We could even choose a specific product here. So the product is, let's say, AI ads and save. So now, anytime someone has submitted this order form or purchased this product, it's going to trigger these automations. So I may have other things in here like adding a tag, adding them to the community, whatever else I want to add there. But the important part is to update that contact field. So I'm going to go here and we're going to choose the fields that we want to update. So I'm going to scroll down and you'll see AI Ads Manager. Now I can put anything I want here. I chose to put the email address because I want to keep track of that, but you could choose any of this information here from your contact or the user or messages. You could add any of these things to update that field. But like I said, I just want to do the email. So what I'm going to do is this is going to be my default settings. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and add that there. I'm also going to add the next tool, which is going to be the AI leads. And again, I'm going to add this custom value because as soon as they sign up, I want to go ahead and put that email in the field because that's what my system is going to try to do. Now, I may get an error or something like that. And then if I do get that error, I want to come back and I want to update that field. So I'll show you that in just a second. Okay. So now we have saved this action. And of course, let's save again. Here we go. And we can call this new member and save. Now let's choose a contact to send this to and test it out. Okay, now when you're testing a contact, you can go to the enrollment history and you'll actually see that contact here in the history. And if we click in there and we scroll down to the fields, you'll see that we have these two fields have auto-populated. I think it's just taking a few minutes for that third one here, but that's really the information that we need. Now, what if we notice in our automations that one of the accounts have not been created? Now, we have some options here, okay? Now, we could contact the customer and say, hey, did you have another account or something like that? But the easiest way would be to actually just create an additional email address. And we can do that using any email by adding the email in there, and we can do plus and then something else. We can make this standard. What I would do is plus MVA for my vision agency. And then now we have this email address that is going to be specific for the AI leads tool. That's much easier than contacting the third party, having them delete or merge the accounts and all of that. Once you have a lot of traffic and a lot of members coming into your program, that definitely becomes a cumbersome process. So what we can do is save that email there. And then we want to go up to the email addresses inside of the contact, and we want to add that email as an additional email. Now, what this allows us to do is it allows us to make this still searchable. So if I am in the AI lead system and I am auditing my accounts and I see this email address, it's very similar to this one, so that automatically helps me troubleshoot. But since I've added this email address to the emails for this contact, when I go search for this email address, it will pull up this contact. So I don't want to change the primary email because that is their membership email address. I'm just adding an additional email so that I can find this client here. So I'm going to go to the contacts here. I'm going to search this email address. You can see that I have found that contact. And if I search this email address, you'll see that I found that contact there as well. This may seem like a small thing, but this is a game changer when you're auditing all of your different accounts that you have when you're using several different third-party softwares. It's absolutely a game changer and very, very important that you're keeping track of all of those things. The last thing you want to do is audit a customer's account who is an active member just because they registered with the wrong email address or you cannot figure out who that account belongs to. If you are a reseller in our program and you have questions, feel free to go to the community tab. You want to go to the events calendar. You can click on today's date to join me in open office hours that will begin as soon as we're done here. If you're in our free community, you can go to that event calendar and join us as well. And again, if you're not a member of our community, you can go to myvisionagency.com. You can click here to register to get access to the free community and open office hours, courses, tools, and more. Thank you all so, so much for joining me today. And I look forward to working with you on open office hours. Go make your vision a reality. Bye.